yeah, moving on from Xbox One X. We've been playing a couple of games this week. I'll let the lads take the first one away. So you guys have been playing Wolfenstein?
Wolfenstein 2. Is it the
New Colossus?
The New Colossus. I get confused between that and the New Order. Just because it's got the word new in it.
So yeah, tell us about it. I've not played it. I've meant to play it, but
so
I didn't.
So fucking good.
Really good game.
It's just 2 hours
of
fun.
He's got it on PS4.
I've got it on PS4.
I've got it on PC.
It's so good. It's one of those games, like, I expected to enjoy it, but not as much as I did.
Yeah, it's just fun.
You get into it, and it's... Right, I'll explain the premise for anyone who doesn't know what Wolfenstein is. It's 1961. You've lost... You're Americans, and you lost the war to the Nazis, and the Nazis basically rule the world.
The Nazis nuked you.
This is the premise of the new Wolfenstein reboot. Wolfenstein game is a bit different.
Yeah, but in terms of the new games, it's like, that's they won the war, and they're in control. And in this one, they completely took over America.
They've took over the world, basically.
But you're part of the resistance in trying to get take back America.
Well,
and it's...
In the game, you literally just start the revolution. That's
basically.
It.
Yeah.
That's it.
I mean, you had part of a resistance group from the first game.
Yeah.
But you obviously...
Yeah. Yeah. Get my run upstairs, get my collar and lights over.
But yeah, you're recruiting a lot more throughout the story. But the story and the characters are what make this game.
Yeah.
It's
you like all of the characters that are like part of your
team, and they're all so
and you
different
don't
to
like
each other.
The enemy that you
oh yeah the yeah. this game does so this, this it does so well at making you hate the characters you're supposed to hate and love the characters you're supposed to love, and it's like all the characters in the cast for your little resistance squad they're so diverse, none of them are like similar, and they're all got their own little quirks, and they all like
even all
interact
the,
with each other.
Even really all the little characters on the ship.
Yeah, then
you speak to them. So one of them hears voices in her head, and she's just like,
"Yeah, they've all got their own little backstory kind of thing, and they're all like your main hub is this U-boat which you robbed from the first game from the Nazis.
Yeah,
and basically it's similar in this game in between missions to like the Citadel in Mass Effect, where you walk around, and you can talk to.
Is it a bit more open world than the first game? No, it's not open world.
But the hub area is basically like going on your ship in Mass Effect.
You can go back to previous areas after a couple of missions to kill Uber commanders that appeared in those areas.
Oh, okay.
And that also lets you go back and pick up any extra things you didn't pick up.
Cool.
So like weapon parts.
It's got side missions which weren't really a thing in the first.
I don't think the side missions really do anything, but
I think they basically unlock extra stuff for you.
What do they unlock?
I'm not going to spoil it. There's certain thing.
So I actually should do them.
Go home!
Do a couple. They just didn't do anything.
You can play the game now. It makes no difference. But
unless it's the more of the gadget things.
Yes, it is.
Oh, it unlocks them.
It's a crazy game, and you're going through, and some of the stuff that happens is just it's mental. Like, you don't expect it.
Is it like
all
over the top, like exaggerated?
It's over the top. But like it's hilarious as well.
That bit at the end.
Well, yeah. You'll know if you've played it.
Yeah.
Me and Corey just watched. Overwatch. Yeah.
It's so over the top. It's there's so many like jokes in it, and all of them. Land like there's none of them that are just like that's not really that funny, but now hold on,
because you've got a very like
particular sense of humor.
This
game like
I'm not lying, Corey.
Jamie agrees.
I agree. Yeah.
Chris is actually like, Jamie agrees, doesn't he? Don't you, Jamie?
I actually do agree.
That's so funny. But when it does have some very serious moments
that
cover stuff like abuse and like obviously racism and all that, and that those moments hit like they should.
They hit And then the game immediately tells you, right, you need to go and murder some Nazis
now. Killing Nazis, it's always going to feel good, isn't it? But, like, for the gameplay, the guns in this game, they feel powerful.
The guns are good. My favourite gun was that heavy laser gun.
That just literally turned everyone to dust.
Yeah, it just melts people.
It was so fucking great. But like,
is it the equivalent of getting the big fucking gun in Doom?
Basically. Not quite, nearly.
There's a few heavy guns that are like...
Whoa, that's a statement.
A heavy gun that is literally the BFG of Wolfenstein.
Yes.
It literally does pretty much the same thing.
Just disintegrates everything in front of it.
Nice.
Yeah.
We might have to play this game.
I would literally say you don't even have to be a fan of first-person shooters to enjoy this game. Because of the story and the characters.
It is quite difficult.
If you're not a big player of first person shooters, you can put it onto a difficulty, which is called the baby difficulty.
It says, "Can I play daddy?" And your character's got,
and
a
got like a little
dummy and a baby.
It's so dumb.
Did you have that through the whole game?
No, it's just like on the screen. Your portrait changes as you go through the
difficulties.
So on the desk, you've all got like blood dripping from your face and scars and everything, and you've got a dimension.
Which difficulty did you play on, Jeremy? Like
normal.
Which one's normal? Because there's two normals. There's the baby one.
Is it like Bring It
normal,
On?
Then there's another normal.
I think it was the other normal, the third
one. The third one. I started on that.
You had to drop it down.
I dropped it down. Aww. Listen, I dropped it down.
Are you surprised?
No.
Oh, God.
How rude. Now, I dropped it down because I wanted to get through it in a week. But I dropped it down for one bit. And then I found myself, it was getting too easy. So I put it back up. But I think there's a learning curve in the game where you've got to just... It's...
Yeah, most of the... A lot of the enemies, even though they're normal enemies, they're still quite powerful.
Yeah.
They can still kill you.
They kill you in a few shots, basically. And if you get a rush of them coming at you...
You can't stand still in this game. If you stand still, you'll die.
It's very mobile. It's similar to Doom. It's very mobile.
Yeah. And if you, especially like I found, you can either dual wield or just use one weapon. At the start, I was using the one weapon, and it was not going well for me at all. And I was like, you know what? Because I was trying to aim down the sights, and that was keeping
you
me
still. Don't have to aim down the sights.
No, I know.
Still just
I know.
I was going to say, you don't get an accuracy.
But I was aiming down. I was because I'm playing a lot of Destiny and a lot of other stuff. Like I aimed down the sights and it just wasn't going well for me. But then when I switched to dual wielding, I was just running around going
fucking people.
I found at the start ammo was a slight issue doing dual wielding at that point. So that was kind of why I didn't switch up the weapons.
Well, I love about this as well, it's not one of those like shooters where your health regenerates to full after waiting for a bit. You have to pick up health, you have to pick up armour, you pick up ammo.
It's old school.
It's proper old school, and that's why I love it. Reminds me of Time Splitters, stuff like that, where you're picking up health, where it's one of those old school shooters.
Did you finish Doom?
I never finished Doom. I played it on the Switch. I just kind of forgot about it. No, do you know what it was? I got really far. It crashed, and I hadn't saved, so I just got pissed off.
It was a really, really, really good game.
I was enjoying it.
Did you play it in the film?
No, I ain't. He is. His version, so I'm going to get him.
Oh, was he?
Yeah.
That look.
I don't know, you know.
I mean, is he better than the film? And Jamie just looked at me like.
But the
I don't know, okay. I don't know. The film was good.
No, it wasn't.
That's what
we're not going to get on this.
You're wrong, Chris.
We'll do that in another conversation.
Is the movie Doom a good movie?
Yes.
Let us know.
The Doom movie is a great movie!
Let's not get on
this. Thank you very much.
We'll do this another topic another time. Because I've got a lot to say
just
about
Chris.
Movie films, game films.
Movie
films, that's a thing now. But
movie films.
I've got work all damn tired.
So what? What about them video games?
Those games.
Yes. Those video game games.
Anyway, back to Wolfenstein.
Back to video game games.
Shut up. Back to Wolfenstein. Like, there's some moments in this game where you're sitting there and you're like, what the fuck just happened?
Yes.
And you're just sitting there for a second just with gawping at it and you're just like, what the fuck? What?
They're not bad what the fucks.
There are some bad what the... Like, there are some what the fucks in terms of, like, shocks.
Well, there's a couple, yeah.
Where you're just like, I can't believe that just happened, kind of thing. I'm not going to... Do not, like, if you're going to play this game, don't Google it, because it will get spoiled. And it's you don't want to get spoiled in anything in this game, because it's a lot more
story based than I was expecting.
I think the first one was a bit,
the story's what makes it.
The story in the first one was okay, but it struggled with pacing, whereas this just, it keeps going and you don't want to stop. And it's like, the first game I came away from halfway through and then went back to it later on, but because of that reason. But for this, I just want to carry on, and it's an exhilarating ride. Literally.
I didn't have that problem with the first game, but that might be because I'd played the older ones, like Return to Castle Wolfenstein, so I had a bit of nostalgia going while I was playing them. So
I think I got like distracted by another game, but like I just got bored at one point, I remember. But not to say that the New Order is a very good game, and it fit, if you play this, you don't have to play the New Order, because you get like a kind of video at the start.
Like, I want to play this, but I haven't finished New Order.
Yeah, you get a video at the start that basically explains
everything
important that happened in the first one. There will be a choice you have to make at the start.
Oh no, no! I played a bit of New Order and I got that far.
I want to know what choice you made now, because it changes the game dramatically.
You can say younger guy or older guy.
Younger guy or older guy. You know what choice I'm on about. You got to make the same choice as me, so you don't get the...
Wing Commander is the one.
I understand how
everyone isn't going to make that choice, because he's the better character.
He is.
He's the better character.
I remember when you're watching the Wolfenstein trailers and you got the guy on the LSD? That's the other guy. So if you choose the Wing Commander, you don't get any of that. But it changes.
You do get other stuff within
that. You get some crazy shit. But it obviously, like, depending on who survives out of these two guys, from how involved he is in the story, like, it's going to change the story dramatically. It's got some replayability there with playing the alternate timeline as well, which is pretty cool. It's my game of the year so far, and that's above Zelda and Horizon.
Well, we all know the reason why you're saying that. Don't
worry. We all know the reason he's saying that. Because
he hasn't played Mario.
It's a particular game he hasn't played!
I haven't either.
From seeing how it goes.
I have an excuse. Because I don't have a Switch. So
I have an excuse. I borrow Kate the game.
Mario!
But
Chris,
move on to me in a second.
Oh my god, you made such a mistake.
The last thing on Wolfenstein is, you need to play this game. It's not that long.
Can I just say, the character you play is not the most badass character in the game. We just leave it at that.
No. Yeah, you... When you get to the end of the game, you'll know.
Even before that, you're just like...
Yeah. I really like... Also, like, your main character, when you played the first game, you didn't really learn much about him. You learn so much about his backstory in this game.
Yeah.
And it really shows you why he is like he is. You know what I mean?
Yeah, it does.
Like, it gives him a...
Has he got
a lot,
that tragic backstory?
It gives him a lot of motivation to be...
Yeah.
Why he's such a
Can I take a whilst? Can I take in a whilst having a dark? Do his wife and child get murdered by Nazis?
No.
Whoa!
See, you think you'd be like,
that's
oh, yeah.
Shock.
But there you go. That's what this game throws twists and turns at you everywhere. There's
is
one
a Nazi
twist.
Experiment child.
Stop guessing, because you're not going to guess it.
Well, there's one. Children haven't been born yet.
There's one. Yeah, his wife is pregnant in this game.
No, I meant him. Like,
she's
his,
not his wife.
Is he pregnant?
Not his wife. his girlfriend. She's pregnant in this game with twins. And
not
that's,
a twist. Okay.
That's a big thing in this game, like, where he's worried about not bringing twins into this world.
Obviously,
kind of thing.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's a huge storyline going through. But there's one thing that happens in the middle of this game. I'm not going to spoil it, obviously, but it's the hugest twist in a video game I've seen. I didn't expect it to happen. And then, the way it was kind of like resolved, I was like, "What the fuck is going on?" It's so good. I would recommend it to you. It's so.
Can
good.
I play the first one?
Yeah, because it gives you a little video at the start.
I know, but
there are some things, like there's certain stuff that happens at the start where if you're not invested in some of the characters, you're not going to care that much.
Yeah,
from the first game, but that you get over that. It's still pretty bad.
Sounds really good.
But you need
it.
So fucking
good. It is a good game.
Okay, I finished it. You can borrow it. It's so fucking good.
I could just watch you play it like I did with
you could do that.
It's so fucking good.
Yeah. Are you finished with Wolfenstein now?
Everyone is that game. We'll move on. If you like that video and want to see more like it, then click this playlist button here. If you happen to want to subscribe to us and check out all our content, then click this amazing, sexy button right here. Look how enticing it is. You know you want to click it. And if you're already subscribed to us, well then, you are already an awesome human being.